Hey guys, it's Trevor. So I am not a fan of using dice to keep track of CP and VP when I'm playing Warhammer 40k. Let's say you score 6 VP. That's great. But if you score 6 more, you have to add another dice. And then another one. And another one. I also tend to forget and just roll some of my VP dice by mistake. Or worse, I just accidentally knock all of them over. And that's why today, I'll be showing you how I made an LED CP and VP counter. But first, a word from our sponsors.
Break that bond! Blood! 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 Kill! Kill!
So the first thing I did was to draw out my circuit diagram. Now, this is not an electronics tutorial, so I will not be going in depth into how every single component works. But I have included a link to the circuit diagram in the description below. Now this circuit is controlled by an Arduino Nano microcontroller, or, in my case, a cheap knockoff that I found online, but, you know, it works the same way. To display the CP and VP, I use two 7-segment LED displays. If you're interested to find out more about how to use these LED 7-segment displays, I've included some links in the description to some tutorials that I personally found very helpful. There are 4 momentary on push button switches with pull down resistors connected to 4 of the digital pins on the Arduino. The first button decreases the CP, the second button increases the CP, the third button decreases the VP, and you guessed it, the fourth button increases the VP. The whole circuit is powered by 4 AA batteries. After planning out my circuit, I went to write my code. And yes, I've included a link in the description to this code. I then built the circuit on a breadboard and tested it to make sure that everything was working correctly. After this, I soldered everything onto stripboard. I decided to make 2 circuit boards, one for the LED displays and one for the Arduino and push buttons. This stripboard layout is also in the link in the description. So here's the LED board. And here's the Arduino, push buttons, and batteries. I connected the two boards with some multicolored jumper cables that reflect my beautiful personality. God f***ing damn it, I love being an engineer. Alright, let's build a frame for this thing. I cut out 2 rectangles of sprues that were slightly bigger than the LED board. As it turns out, the sprues from my Gene Stealers had 2 rectangles that were exactly the right size. Thank you, Hivemind! I trimmed off all the random pointy bits. I then cut off 4 small straight pieces of sprue, Jesus Christ, that's hard to say. I sanded down the edges. Then I used them and some plastic glue to attach the 2 big rectangles together. At this point, I had a nice little enclosure for my LED board. I cut out 4 long pieces of sprue and attached them with plastic glue. This gave me a nice signboard-shaped frame that could house both the LED board and the jumper cables. After this, I bought a cheap plastic box. I cut out a hole for the jumper cables. And then I drilled 4 holes for the buttons. After putting everything inside, I realized that I'd forgotten to drill a hole for the power switch. Take that, safety! Alright, time to attach everything together. I used a glue gun to attach the signboard-shaped frame to the plastic box. Ta-da! I cut out some cardboard panels to put over the empty parts of the frame. I attached them with a glue gun. For the front panel, I cut out 2 holes that were the same size as the LED 7-segment displays. Yeah, it's all coming together. To make it look more grimdark, I grabbed a penknife and basically just attacked all the cardboard. I also set fire to some parts of it. If my girlfriend is watching this, I had some water nearby to put it out, I swear. I grabbed my glue gun and applied some glue all over the sides, just to break the shape for when I apply texture to it. I grabbed some sawdust and mixed it with some white glue. Then I slopped it all over the base. After a couple of days, it had dried to this craggly, earthy texture that I was pretty pleased with. I primed everything in white because it's the only color primer I own. Alright, I hope you guys are ready to see some amateur-ass painting. I applied a base coat of silver mixed with black paint for all the cardboard bits. Then I painted the base with some black mixed with brown paint. I painted all the ripped and burned bits with a lighter silver paint. Then I stippled in some orange followed by some red paint into all the ripped bits. I really wanted to make them look kind of corroded or rusty. After this, I applied a wash directly from the pot into all the ripped bits. And yes, I know Duncan Rhodes says, "Oh, send your washes with water." Well, you know what, Duncan Rhodes, maybe I want my rusty bits to look splotchy. I dry brushed some black in and around the edges of the burned bits. Then I also washed them with brown. I then flicked some red paint at different points to create some blood splatters. Then I grabbed some neon green paint and painted on some graffiti. After this, I applied a black wash mixed with water in about a 50-50 ratio all over the model. After it was dry, I decided that the rusty bits didn't quite look rusty enough, so I dry brushed in some more orange and red. I then did a bright silver dry brush over all the metal-looking parts of the model. For the base, I first dry brushed on some brown, followed by some khaki. Painting mud, a good reflection of my skills. I cut out some little cardboard letters to label the different counters. After basing them, I painted them bright red. I don't really think this red color goes, but it's really visible from afar, which prevents confusion during games. I stuck some modeling grass on the base to make the entire thing look less ugly. I attached the rear panel with some Velcro. This will give me easy access in future in case I need to troubleshoot anything. Alright, time to put the electronics in. At this point, I realized that the LED board was jiggling about a bit. So I cut two bits of sprue, and I glued them in just above the two lips of the holes that I cut for the LED displays. I attached some Velcro to the bottom side of the sprues, and to the top of the LED displays. After that, there was no more jiggling. Alright, and this is my LED CP and VP counter for Warhammer 40k games. Now, you can make just one and laugh as your opponent uses their primitive way of counting CPs and VPs with dice. Or you could, you know, make a second one just because you're nice, but the choice is yours. Alright, that's it. Hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, please consider hitting that like and subscribe button. And I'll see you all next time.